finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. Oh, the finished work of the cross is all that I ever could need. Oh, yes, the finished work of the cross is all that I ever could need. Finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. Finished work of the cross is all that I ever could need. Yes, the finished work of the cross is all that I ever could need. The finished work of the cross. Got the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever could need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever could need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever need. Oh, it is finished. It is sealed. Christ the victor revealed. Oh, it is finished. It is sealed. Christ the victor revealed. It is finished. It is sealed. Christ the victor. Finished work of the cross brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever could need. It's It's the finished work of the cross. Got the finished work of salvation. Finished work of the cross. He's all that I ever could need. In no grave, where is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Your grave, where is your victory? The King of Kings has rescued me. Your grave, where is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Your grave, where is your victory? The King of Kings has rescued me. Your grave, where is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Your grave, where is your victory? King of Kings, set me free.
Christ, the victor, prevail. Oh, it is finished.
the liberty Christ has set me free. Yes, I will stand fast in the liberty Christ has purchased for me. Yes, I will stand the liberty where Christ has set me free. Yes, I will stand fast in the liberty Christ has purchased for me. In no grave where is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Oh, grave, is your victory? The King of Kings has rescued me. Oh, grave, is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Oh, grave, is your victory? The King of Kings has rescued me. Oh, grave, is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Oh, grave. King of Kings, set me free. Oh, 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 oh. We lift up our voices and pray to you, Lord. We lift up our voices in praise to you, oh Lord. We lift up our voices in praise to you, oh Lord. King forever. King forever. King. Praise you. victory. Christ the King has set me free. Your grave, where is your victory? The King of Kings has rescued me. Your grave, where is your victory? Christ the King has set me free. Your grave, where is your victory? The King of Kings has rescued me. And I will stand fast in the liberty that Christ has purchased for me. Oh, I will stand fast in the liberty Christ has set me free. Oh, free indeed. Oh, I will stand. The finished work of salvation. The finished work of the cross.
The finished work of salvation.
It's the finished work of the cross. The finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever could need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever could need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation. It's the finished work of the cross. Is all that I ever could need. It's the finished work of the cross. Brought the finished work of salvation.
Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I praise you. And I will worship you with thanksgiving forever. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I praise you. I will worship before you forever. Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I praise you. I will worship before you forever. Let the earth sing praise to the Lord of hosts. Let the air shout for joy. Hallelujah. Let the earth sing praise to the King of Kings. Let the earth sing praise to the Lord of hosts. Let the air shout for joy to the King of Kings. Let the earth sing praise to the Lord our God. Let the earth sing praise and rejoice in him. Rejoice in the Lord our God, our King. Can't hear you at all. Oh, let the earth sing praise to the Lord of hosts. Let the earth sing praise to the King of Kings. Let the earth rejoice in God our Savior. Let the earth sing praise to the Lord of hosts. Let the earth sing praise to the King of Kings. Let the earth rejoice in God alone, our Savior. Everybody rejoice. I will rejoice. I will make known his deeds among the people. I will rejoice in the Lord my God. I will rejoice in the Lord most high. Come sing praise. Lord our King, rejoice, rejoice. Let the earth now sing, rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Let the earth now sing, rejoice.
Get us there, hallelujah, hallelujah. Get us out of the day. Oh, Mandera, see, Maradera, see, hallelujah. Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, rejoice. Hallelujah.
Let me hear you sing.
No.
I want to hear you sing in the spirit. You know why? Because I believe Father is like, come on, let me hear you sing in the spirit. That's what I believe. Yeah. <Woo-hoo-hoo>. Cosi te ribaya remobra babo soto elo bunzi segi a romon babale o pusisti carana. Pepri basi da elo lo mangi a robo primenea. Zebra vai elo bususiki. Vai a romo mani. Ha 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 ha. Holy is thy Lord. Holy, holy is thy Lord most high. Holy, holy is the Lord our God. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord. Hallelujah. Holy, holy, holy. The Lord. Yes, everybody just lift your hands towards heaven. Thank you, Father, for the anointing of the Holy Ghost upon every person standing in this place right now, watching by the web. Father, I thank you for the outpouring of that which only belongs to heaven. We pray, Father, that there would not be a single person without that glory. The transcendence goes far beyond, way above anything that is human. Father, I pray that your people will come to understand that when the river flows, sickness goes. That when the river flows, disease can't stand. That when the river flows, everything that belongs to the powers of darkness in the man becomes irrelevant. And that those, O Lord, who do not know this realm will press into this realm as found by them. That no longer will they just accommodate ordinary. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that your people will no longer accommodate ordinary, but by the faith which comes by you and by your word. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ that there would come a stand in the hearts of your people everywhere, and especially here in this place, that would press in till they take hold of that which is very different than anything that belongs to this world and to this earthly realm. Father, let the joy begin. Let the shout begin. Let the glory begin. Let the faith begin. Let the outpouring of heaven begin in a way, oh God, that transcends man. God has something for you that goes far beyond anything that belongs to you, that looks like you. It's heaven. He's got a smile that's bigger than any smile that can be produced by the happiness of men. He's got a prosperity and a wealth that goes far beyond anything that the greatest mind and the greatest achievers could ever have or gain. Father has things for us that we've just never been willing to fight the battles for and press in to have. We've been willing to accommodate whatever it is we think we've got, because some people just have a hard time dealing with their failure.
But when you step into God's success, you just begin to get to a place where it's not dealing with your failure, it's not tolerating it anymore. It's just coming to a place of not tolerating it. So many people are held back by all their concepts and their ideas. They're held back by their need for all the things that they've itemized in their life that they were taught from a child that they should have. And Father wants to do something that goes beyond all of those things that we've thought and that we've believed. He wants to do it right now. He wants you to do it right now. He wants you to open your mouth so that He can fill it. He does. He wants to take you to a place that you've never been before. Hello? And that's scary. And that's challenging. And there's some famine in it. And there's some concerns and there's some challenges that really threaten your own life in it. And it's the surrender up of all the things that you believe you were promised. A surrendering up and a sacrificing of all those things that you believed that you were promised. But should you stand faithful with God, He has caused you to inherit the worlds that are to come. Should you stand faithful with God, He'll take you beyond anything that your hand could have ever achieved, your mind could have ever thought, your heart could have ever desired. This is what the Lord says. Oh, that there will be a people today that would respond to the voice of God, that would recognize the things that He's described in His Word goes beyond those things that we have attained to or that we have thought of. That it gets greater and higher and deeper with every passing day, that every moment is a sacred realm where God can be found in ways that go beyond and surpass the understanding. Oh, if men would understand the riches of heaven instead of being so captivated by the riches of the earth. Oh, that men would understand the glory and the prosperity that Father has ordained throughout eternity, so that men's hearts and desires would turn towards Him and no longer be captivated by something purely earthly, where the moth corrupts and where rust corrupts, where thieves break through and steal. Father will change your passions. He will change your desires. He will change your emotions. He will change your affections if you'll go after Him. If you'll take that, see, God gave faith to every man. He not only gave faith to every man, a measure of it, He gave hunger and thirst to every person. In every person's life, there's some hunger for God. And when that hunger is nurtured through that wonderful gift of grace that comes to us by Jesus Christ, it explodes on the inside of us and it becomes the insatiable desire of heaven in our being. I said it becomes an insatiable desire of heaven in our being. And it does not matter how much God's power and glory is revealed to you and through you. You're just desperate for more as though you've had nothing yet. I said you're just desperate for more as though you've had nothing yet. And I'm going to tell you what that results in. The human image leaves and the divine comes. Human expressions fade away and the divine expressions of the Spirit of the Lord begin to take over. Personal ambitions are retired forever. Retired, I said, forever. Human understanding and processing and thinking and interpreting all that is around you no longer has any value. You don't have you're not in a reward system and an honor system of men anymore. You don't even think about it because you're standing there with your mouth wide open, your jaws basically hit the floor, and you're beholding something so glorious and you want so much more. I said, you're beholding something so glorious. Oh, no. The price of this is that you have to daily deal with all the other things that steal and vie for your affections. You can't have this and nurture all the other affections and all the other desires and all the other earthly interests, because it will just drown out heaven's desire. But if you say, no, I don't want that. Father, I want you. And then nothing. No, no, I don't want that either. Father, I want you. Oh, well, that looks pretty, but no, I don't want it. I want you. Yeah. Oh, yeah, well, that's interesting, and I can see that everybody else is really fascinated by it, but I don't want that. I want you. There's where the growth and the maturity comes, but what happens is so many of God's people go, oh, really? I can have that too? Oh, yeah, well, I'd like to have that. Please, can I have that? okay, I'm going to go pursue that. And then we run after something earthly. If you be risen with Christ, set your affections on things above, not on things of this earth. For you're dead. For you're dead. I've had so many people talk to me about a balance. There's no such thing as balance. It's total abandonment. Jump in head first, sink to the bottom, and breathe. It's you are dead. I'm going to stand up here because you're standing. You are dead. You. The you. You're dead. And your life is hid with God in Christ. When Christ, who is your life, shall appear, then shall you appear also with him in glory. Now everybody wants this, but they want to have earth and heaven too. Can't have it. Cannot. God says you cannot serve God and mammon. You will love the one and hate the other. Cannot. Cannot. Hard thing for people to hear. Cannot serve God and mammon too. Can't have earthly interest in heaven too. Can't have all the things that you want and all the things that you believe you need and then be caught up with him in glory. Come on, people. Come on now. Listen to me. Make your 10,000-year plan. And once you've done that, you can make your 30-year plan because it'll be in right perspective. Because if your 30-year plan doesn't match your 10,000-year plan, you're in trouble. Because this is, I'm going to tell you right now, this is barely even a letter and a comma in the ages. This is, in the volumes of the libraries of eternity, this is barely a letter with a comma. This is like a O with a comma. Are you with me? O, comma. We're in the O right now. O. O. And so many people are just fascinated with the little bit, the stuff that is around. And Father wants to give you an understanding heart. He doesn't want you to be as the ostrich or as the wild donkey who has no knowledge, no understanding concerning the things of life. An ostrich who no sooner does she have her young and pay attention to it, and immediately she forgets it. He wants to give us an understanding heart. Hallelujah. Father doesn't want us to have a heart of an animal. Men have been prophesying over men, declaring over men that they have the heart of the animal. And I know that men more, sometimes in many respects actually does things and allows things that even animals will not allow. When God took away the understanding heart from Nebuchadnezzar, he gave him a heart of a beast, a wild beast. He knew nothing about who he was. Lived from day to day for his food and scratched for his own existence. And so many people live in that realm. They've never become not even that which God created man to be when he shaped him in his image and his likeness as a human in a human realm in many respects. True. But Father has taken us far beyond that and he's brought us into the divine. I tell you, he's brought us into the divine. I said he's brought us into the divine, not just the vine, the divine. But of course, you got to be in the vine to be in the divine. Hallelujah. You've got to be in the vine. Christ Jesus is a branch. You've got to bottle every day. Thank you, Father. You can be seated. You know, did you know that Jesus is here right now?
Yes.
I have a cloak around me right now. It's the cloak of the Holy Ghost. The Lord reminded me this morning. He said, you know how popular I am in the anointing? He reminded me this morning. He said, you know how popular I am in the anointing? He said, Herod, Pontius Pilate, the Gentiles, and all the people of Israel are set against me. You didn't hear what I said. You didn't hear what I said because you guys, listen to me. You're looking for the wrong thing. He said, you want to know how popular I am in the anointing that I have? All the nations of the earth and all the peoples of the earth were set against me, Herod, Pontius Pilate, the Gentiles, and the people of Israel. The world will hate you, cannot know you, and you can't know it
it's crucified to you and you're crucified to it, and that gets you basically on the starting ground. Amen. Amen. Now you're at the starting line and you're ready now to begin to run the race. And Father will take us, listen, I'm going to tell you right now, I don't care how many challenges you've been through. I can't help it that you and we have done so many things wrong, expecting God's right results. Listen to me. God's plan works. His word works. Father will bring you into every dimension of every good thing that pertains to life and godliness and everything about Him, all of His divine power and all of His glory. I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health in direct proportion to soul prosperity. That's good soulish realm for you right there. Everybody wants to trichotomize, dichotomize, and other cotomizes of the person that God has made in His image and His likeness. As your soul prospers, which means really in both Hebrew and Greek, the soul or soulish means your very existence, your life. Doesn't mean these other things people say. It's just other philosophy. It's philosophical infiltration of all people's opinions and what God has to say. Messes it all up, gets everybody confused. Now we don't know what to pursue. But God wants you to prosper and be in health, even as your life in Him, your soul in Him, your being in Him. Because soul or nephesh, or what we would say in Greek language, psuche, okay, which is not derived from the derivatives that some people make it to derive from. They need to go back and study some more, okay? But it literally is the whole of your being. Because God has made the whole of our being His, spiritual. Our body has been redeemed in the sense that it's God's temple. And it's got resurrection life in it, even though it's corruptible. And it's dying. And it's decaying. And it's going to go, though my outward man perish, that's what Paul said, though my outward man perish, right? It's still the temple of God. Huh? Somebody said, this scripture didn't say that. Oh, yes, it does. Somebody said, oh, you hybridized two verses of scripture. I absolutely did, and in context, and without any violation, my body, hallelujah, is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Even though it perishes, huh? I've got a building and you have a building in heaven made without hands, made of God, eternal. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And we groaning to put off this tabernacle, to put on a more glorious one. That's fine, but it's still the temple of the living God. And Father wants it to be sacred in your life. He wants it to be sacred to you. Our bodies are His. Our spirit is His. We're supposed to glorify Him in our body and our spirit, which are His. Our soul is His. Therefore, He preserves our whole body, soul, and spirit blameless. It's blameless. Now, there is the concept of the redemption of the purchased possession, and I know some of you that are very skilled in the word. That verse of scripture, verse 1:16 popped up while I said that, and that's fine, because although it is set apart unto God, though it is sanctified, did you know? And that's what I mean. It's sanctified. Resurrected life is in it, and when we're talking about the purchased possession, or the redemption of the purchased possession, we're talking about the glorified body. I'm redeemed. I'm redeemed. I'm 100% Holy Ghost certified redeemed. And I want you to be 100% Holy Ghost certified redeemed. You know, there's something that I labor for and that I'm contending for. It's the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. John described it like this. He said, we have seen that eternal life, referring to Christ Jesus, He has been manifested unto us, and we now show Him unto you. There was an encounter in their life where the glory of heaven, the glory of the person of Christ Jesus, was so allowed to be manifested and revealed in their lives that they were able to also reveal Him. Paul, in the thesis of the New Testament, in Galatians chapter 1, verse 16, says, I come to know or understand by revelation that Father purposed to reveal His Son, speaking of Christ Jesus, in Him. And He said, and immediately I conferred not with flesh and blood, but went out into Arabia, and there for 3 years was given abundance of revelation. That's what you read when you read the epistles of Paul, which makes up approximately 2/3 of the New Testament. The abundance of revelation, which was all about Christ Jesus being revealed in him. And it wasn't just him. It's a grace, as he shared, that has been made available to all people, is what God has ordained. It's not something that it's Christianity A, Christianity B, or Christianity C. Door number one, door number two, or door number three. There's only one door. It's his. It's Jesus. Hallelujah. We go out from this realm into that realm. And now we begin to deal with all the things that vie for our attention and vie for our affection. I'm laboring for one thing. When Christ Jesus, the eternal Word, was manifested as the living Word, he came revealing the entirety of the Word of God and the entirety of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Jesus Christ came revealing the entirety of the Word and in the entirety of the anointing without measure. Father gave him the Spirit without hold, the Holy Ghost without measure. Hallelujah. And in that, he began to show us a beginning of something that he wanted us to have, a beginning, that now we grow and mature into all the fullness of God. Hello. While you're busy with your bills, you're busy with your thrills, you're busy with all your other earthly interests and acting like you're going to live forever and that there's a gold mine here, I'm going to tell you right now, it's not so. There is another realm God has given us, understanding hearts to lay hold of, insight to grasp, wisdom and revelation to function in. And it is the realm of the eternal. It is the realm that you better be careful, because if you teach your children how to function in it, they won't be interested in all the earthly stuff so that Satan can steal them away quickly, but they'll be interested in the heavenly things, and then they will grow and mature beyond that which you have known or understood. I'm going to tell you right now, with the anointing, with the manifest presence of the living God and other dimensions of the anointing that you grasp a hold of, and especially if you want to really understand the manifest presence of the Holy Spirit, you're going to have to understand these other dimensions of the anointing. I'm going to talk a little bit about it. And if you will, if you'll grab a hold of these things, what's going to happen is that you're going to be able to agree with God and step into all the Father has for you. If you contend for the faith, that the faith being that you and I have been born of God, that we're one with him, that we're no longer earthly, we're heavenly. That as we've borne the image of the earthly, now we bear the image of the heavenly. That we truly are citizens of heaven. Our conversation is in heaven. That we no longer live, that Christ lives. As soon as I start talking about people, you're no longer earthly, people start looking at me cross-eyed, and then it goes back out that way, and then it kind of, you know, tries to focus in again. What on earth is he saying? Because we want to hold on to the earthly. Stop. No, you really don't. If the trumpet of the Lord were sound right now, none of you would want to hold on to anything earthly. I want to get rid of all your earthly attachments. You want to be fully identified with the Father, with Christ Jesus, and with the Holy Ghost at the moment that you encounter him. Anything that's not identified with him, you're ashamed of, and I want you to be ashamed of it now. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. I want to get it out of your theology. I want to get it out of your action. I want to get it out of your choices. Because reality of it is where you move in spiritually all comes down to your decisions. People are set free by decisions that they make. They are bound by decisions that they make. It all comes down to choices and decisions. People say, how do I get right with God? By a decision. How do I make up for the mistakes? By a decision. How do I backslide? By a decision. How do I move further away from God? By a decision. By a choice that you make. I want you to start making, God wants you to start making choices. Amen. And decisions all based in him, because that's what his word is, choices and decisions. And now my choices and decisions are made for me. They're all written out for me. Here, choose this and live. Wow, I would have never thought of choosing that. Well, choose it and watch what's going to happen to you. Don't mix it with your philosophy and your ideology. I want you to listen to this. Jacob, who was called Israel, the one who contended with God, wrestled with God, did not let go of God, had some serious challenges to do with himself. He has a revelation and he suddenly realizes, wait a minute, he's been in the house of God all this time and didn't know it. And many of you are that way right now. maybe that are watching me by web, maybe here in this place, you're in the house of God, you didn't even know it. I mean, you didn't even know your body is the temple of the living God. You didn't know how sacred you are. You didn't know how easy it is to hear from the Holy Ghost, how easy it is to be led by Him. We make it all too touchy-feely, people. His Word is powerful. It's living. And it's God the Holy Ghost that hooks up with His Word. And every time you choose His Word and you yield to Him and you do it relationally, the power of the Holy Ghost is manifested even in a greater dimension in your life. So when Jacob has this revelation, well, I'm in the house of God and I didn't even know it. He saw angels ascending and descending, and they weren't just climbing up a ladder. You know what I'm saying? Are you listening to me? Hello. And you got some coming up one ladder and some coming down another ladder, one by one. You know, we get some wild concepts going, especially when, you know, some of these Sunday school teachers go to teaching Sunday school and they're trying to get a little bit too creative. No. Hallelujah. It was a wide open stairway of access between heaven and earth. I mean, that's pretty much, what, in a lot of respects, it's what Jesus was saying to Nathanael. He was saying to Nathanael, you know, because when he told him, I saw you under the fig tree, I'm going to tell you something. There was something going on under the fig tree with Nathanael and the Lord at that moment. Because the Lord was preparing Nathanael's heart, who became known as Bartholomew. He was preparing Nathanael's heart for an encounter with the divine. And he said, you've not seen nothing yet. From this day forward, you're going to see angels ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. Nothing's changed. I'm telling you right now, the angels of the Lord ascending and descending upon His church. But that is nothing compared to the fact that God, who fills all heaven and earth, is with us right now. His name is the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. He's with us and He's in us. And He wants to show us how to lay hold of all the promises and all the blessings of God. And we're going through the crisis and the challenges of our decisions and our choices, and people are imposing upon us, especially in a Western civilization. Do you know that you're living in Greek society? But they're thinking, do you know you're living in a Greek society? Did you know this is not designed by God? Did you know that Alexander the Great had a huge impact on the world? Still exists today? How many of you studied Western civilization in school? You're living in a Western civilization. You're living in a Greek society. It has ruled since that day. And I'm not going to talk about that. I got a book coming out here in just a little bit. Charisma's doing for me. And somebody said, oh, you should let Charisma do it. Why not? And they got a great distribution, man. Yeah, they're all excited about it. God's made them excited about it. They're going to publish the thing from here to yon. Amen. And people are going to get touched by the power of God. Hallelujah. But at any rate, what did he do? What did Jacob do? He took the oil and he anointed it. He had already had an understanding of how to take something and set it apart and consecrate it so it would be authorized. And it would be authorized and sanctified. And that means it would be made holy, a place, a consecrated place now to meet with God. You and I have been made a consecrated, sanctified, holy place to meet with God. We're the altar. We're the meeting place. We're a meeting place. You're a meeting place. You're the meeting place. You're more than the meeting place. You're the habitation of the living God. He wants to open up your eyes and give you insight to recognize His inheritance that He has in you. Now, you can flip that around and say, I can get it if Ephesians 1:18 said, I could have my eyes of my understanding open that I might know what my inheritance is in Him. Because I can look at the inheritance that He gave to Israel and say, wow, that's an inheritance. But He's got an inheritance in you. He wants to bring forth the glory of His only begotten Son. He wants to bring forth the glory of that which He began when He shaped Adam in His image and His likeness. Somebody said, oh, we're restored back to that. No, we're far beyond that. I said, far beyond that. I'm not recreated in Adam. I'm recreated in God, Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus, far beyond Adam. Far greater than Adam. Come on, get your theology right. We're talking about God now. Come, made us one with Himself, and we have a hard time processing this. Why? Because we're attracted to all the little shiny things. It's how you catch trout. It doesn't have to have any food. It's just got to be shiny. And the trout's on it. And he's hooked. And he becomes for the frying pan. Meat for the frying pan. They used to go in the jungles of the Congo, go into the jungles of Papua New Guinea and Indonesia with just little shiny brass trinkets, little mirror-like things. And the natives were so fascinated by it, they would give them literally tons of gold for just another little shiny thing. Oh, that's a rock? You can have that rock. Can I have the shiny thing? They had no understanding, no value of what was really in front of them. I'm going to tell you, people, we've got to watch out because we live out the same kind of choices and decisions, and we don't know it because we're just ignorant on another level. Are you listening to me? Where we're trading in our riches, the joy divine and glory for things that do not satisfy, things that cannot prosper you, cannot bless you. You walk with God, you're going to be blessed. Hallelujah. You may have to fight some fights. You may have to go through some wilderness. You may have to go up against some bitter water. You may have Mara. You may have a lot of different events. You may have to trust God to the point of a miracle to speak to the rock and watch how spirit knowledge works so that the water will come out. You may have to go through intense things ultimately to step over into a realm of that which Father has already ordained. But you know what? I know that that journey can be not extended, but it can be abbreviated. Huh? I would rather live in rejoicing with joy unspeakable and full of glory than to live in heaviness through many times of troubles because you don't get it. Huh? Because you're not willing to be tried. You're not willing to be proven. I took him to the wilderness and I led him through the wilderness that I might prove them whether they would live by the word alone. Huh? I might prove them and show them that man does not live by bread alone, but by every word which proceeds out of the mouth of God. This is the challenge, people, to our thinking, where we process by the word of God, his divine choices, his principles. I'm telling you, right now, because if you come into this place because you've got a hungry heart and you purpose to serve God, there is an event spiritually that's happened in your life that just because you're here, it's happening. Not because of anything you're thinking or trying to do, just because you're here. The word of God, for example, is spirit and life. Just by because you're hungry for God in a true and sincere heart, just by reading it, your life's being changed. Your spirit is growing. The things about who you are is prospering. It's strength to your bone. It's health to your Mara. It truly is. And yet people don't realize it. And so somehow it's a barricade for them and it's a hardship for them and they can't find time to do it. That's such a revelation that your life is so upside down that you're not seeking first the kingdom of God. You're seeking first you. And you're wondering why you got all that trouble. All God did was boil the pot and bring all the trouble to the surface so you could see it and smell it.
Yes.
And it don't look good and it don't smell good. And now you're doubting whether or not God loves you. He loves you. Just showing you what the problem is holding back. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
To understand what he did, how sacred he made you. See, this is where the anointing, the masach, is described this first time. Then that anointing oil, we could all the way over, of course, in the New Testament, we understand truly it is all about the Holy Ghost. It's a representation of the Holy Ghost. And from the masach, it ultimately was revealed the Messiah, or the Messiah, who is Christ Jesus, the anointed one, the anointing to the anointed one. And in any case, it's the one who's set apart by God, sanctified. In other words, the word for sanctification, both in the Hebrew language and the Greek language, is to be made holy. People have got all these different theories and ideas about what it means to be sanctified simply because they come from a lineage of people that don't believe that we've been made holy, that somehow we're going to earn the holiness. It's a gift. God gave us a gift.
Yes.
And the deal for the gift was he's going to give it to us. We're going to be so holy even as he is holy. Okay, you don't believe that? Then you try to make yourself holy even as he is holy. And then tell me how you're doing it. Huh? And show me an example of somebody that did that. No, it's a gift. It's a gift. Be holy even as I am holy, because he gave a gift of holiness. Because it's be in a state, not achieve, not obtain, be, to exist. Hallelujah. How do I get to exist? By a miracle where the Spirit of the Lord came upon me and he anointed me. See, the oil, when oil was poured out by Samuel upon Saul's head, it represented the Holy Ghost coming upon him. And that literally took place. He did it by symbol with this holy anointing oil. And then it wasn't long, just by the evening of the next day, the Holy Ghost came upon him and changed his heart. And he became consecrated and sanctified with a divine power and a divine ability to be a king. Yeah. God gave the same thing. You can read about it in Leviticus chapter 8. God gave the same thing. You read about it, of course, in Exodus chapter 28 as well. He gave the same ability to the priest the ability to come and stand before him and minister to all the sacred things so that the priest could touch the sacred things and the sacred things to be sacred, so that the priest could come stand in the holies of holies and be acceptable to God and not fry, because God said, don't come near me. You're different from me. You're from another realm. You belong to a place called darkness, and I'm not integrating with you. I'm not having anything to do with you. You have to receive a special anointing. Come in here. God's given us a special anointing. The Spirit of the Lord came upon us, and he made a new creation. What we see with Christ Jesus is that he was born of the Holy Ghost. That which was conceived in her was of the Holy Ghost. We've been born of the Holy Ghost. That which was conceived in us is of the Holy Ghost. Hello. But what happens is you start listening to all the information around you in this world, and it describes to you something different, and you begin to drift away. And you begin to believe other things. You believe earthly things about yourself, and thus you cannot move in the divine. You cannot move in the faith. You cannot move in the power that has been given to you. There has to come a place of an agreement. You can see there in Genesis. You can see there in Exodus. And you can see in really in the whole of the five books of Moses, you can see the anointing creating a place and a state of holiness and really being all about being given the ability to minister to God, being given the ability to interact with him, being certified and authorized and even given authority when it came to the priest to enter into the holies of holies. But then when you move on from there and you go into the judges and you go Joshua and the judges, suddenly the anointing takes on a different dimension, and now you see its power to be able to deliver, to drive out all of the enemies of God. These things are resonant in us. But we don't allow them to grow because we're too busy doing other things. People, I'm going to tell you right now, you need to be in a Holy Ghost meeting every day. Yes. Where's Joshua Matos? Joshua, I want Joshua to share tonight, because something, just tell you what happened. I'll just tell you right now in case some of you aren't back here tonight. Joshua took up the mantle or took up the challenge. I said, listen, you can have a Holy Ghost meeting, and I've said it over and over and over again, but I got really radical the other night, and I said, you got to do this. I'm going to spank you if you don't, kind of thing. You know, I said, you need to do this. And I said, you need to pray for an hour until, of course, I didn't say, I'm going to spank you. Okay, get over it. Okay, so I just said, look, you got to do it. Come on, people. I mean, if I got something good and you're not willing to come and have it, I'm going to say, what's wrong with you?
That's right.
There's something good over here. What's your problem? You're sitting there telling me you got a problem. I got the answer out of here. Don't sit there. Go get the answer.
Amen.
And so I said, pray for an hour until the glory comes. And Joshua took it up, and he said he prayed for an hour. He said the hour was over. He said, the glory didn't come. He didn't really feel the change in the atmosphere. So he said, you know what? I'm going to just go ahead and go on until the power and the glory of heaven comes. You know, he had his first Holy Ghost meeting outside of church. People, I mean, once you find this realm, you're going to live in this realm. And it just doesn't become an event. It grows from an event to a continuous bosataranaya pakaya, globandora sikanama, and dabosendeya pra. And it's not touchy-feely. It's an experience of your oneness with God. And all you do is you begin to live out the Word of God that much more effectively, because it's the power of the Holy Ghost that gives us the ability to express the Word. See, Christ Jesus, the eternal Word, was expressed by the Holy Ghost. Why? He was conceived by the Holy Ghost. The eternal Word was made in a holy embryo by the Holy Ghost and was revealed by the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. By an anointing, by the presence of the living God, by the power of God. He said, I've been anointed. How? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he's anointed me. The Holy Ghost has anointed me. You've been anointed. You've not been anointed just to be a priest, to minister before the presence of the Lord. You've also been anointed by the power of God. Listen, I'm going to tell you right now, the powers of distraction, the things that the enemy has tried to do to stop you, in the name of Jesus, you need to rise up against it. You need to rise up against it, and you need to destroy it. Somebody said, oh, no, I'm just waiting for God to destroy it. No, he has given you the delivering anointing. Because, see, that's where Masach went to Messiah. It's the person who can now say to the sun and moon, don't move. We're busy over here driving out the enemies. Huh? That's where Samson or Shamgar or Gideon, they were anointed as deliverers. They were messiahs. They were messiahs. They were deliverers. They were saviors. This thing came upon us by the anointing to be able to drive out every demon spirit, every enemy of God, everything that opposes those things that God has purposed to bless us with, dear people. I'm talking about everything that belongs to life and godliness. I'm talking about every dimension of His blessings, not just a few.
Amen.
All of them.
Amen.
All of them.
Amen.
All of them. God didn't just anoint you to be a king. What an anointing that was. Or to be a prophet. What a great anointing that was. He's anointed you and I to be sons of God. He, as many as received Him, He gave them authority. He authorized us. He anointed us. He made us a new creation. He brought forth something that is brand new. Do you live in the brand new or do you live in the kind of new? Because a lot of people live in the kind of new. What are you now? Are you 50-50, 75-25? Are you 90-10? What are you? Has the root of iniquity, have you dug it out yet, or did you find another sprout? All of these crazy notions and crazy ideas that steal away from us who God has made us. The faith. This is the faith. I'm contending for the faith that was once delivered unto man. The expression of the Word of God in its fullness. The expression of the Holy Ghost in its fullness. We've watched this, some people go after the expression of the Holy Ghost. They're just ready to have a good time in the Holy Ghost. I love having a good time in the Holy Ghost, but there's also walking out the Word, because I've watched too many people have a good time in the Holy Ghost and they never walk out the Word. Where's the disconnect? Hello. You know, okay, yeah, you've received the anointing. Now what are you going to do with it? You receive the presence of the living God. Holy Ghost is all about revealing what? The Word. That's what He's about. That's what I'm going to send you a Holy Ghost. What is He going to do? Reveal the Word. He's going to reveal me, Christ Jesus. Yeah. It's the Holy Spirit that reveals Jesus. He's the living Word that expresses the fullness of the written Word. Hallelujah. But you're going to have to know the Word of God. You say, it's just so laborious. Laborious. It's food. Is it labor for you to eat? We need to get you a checkup. You just can't eat. You can't swallow. It doesn't go down good. It's sour in your belly. It just, you know, you just don't have time. Well, somebody needs to give you some good food. Listen, there is nobody who has that in their right mind who has a problem sitting down at the table three times a day. Huh? Your body is screaming and demanding it. Did you know that your spirit can begin to scream and demand the supply, the nurture of the Word of God? You'd be like a newborn babe going, wah, wah, crying out. We had a little calf born last night, and the calf, and that's what the same thing is about the calves. When they're really healthy, they latch on and will not take, they will not release. Because they just hungry. They just on. They want the milk. They got to have the nourishment. Oh, dear people, to begin to conceptualize what God has done when He authorized you and gave you the authority to be sons of God. God Father put you in charge. Right now, most of us behave pretty much like Naomi. We have no concept of somebody else is in charge. She does not have hardly any concept. She believes that the whole universe was created for her. She does that, and it must serve her. And it's going to take a while for her to recognize that from a human realm, the universe does not respond to her beck and call or demand. Huh? And people have been well trained in that now by the time they're your age, for the most part. Well, Father wants to show you some things that are so much more beautiful, that when you live as His servant, when you live doing His will, walking in His Spirit, being who He created you to be, suddenly the whole dynamics of things change. Suddenly you begin to move in spirit knowledge, and you can speak to the rock and the water comes out. See, I'm already doing that. I speak to the rock and the water comes out. Huh? The rock, Christ Jesus. I say, Lord, give me to drink. Woo! I talked to Jesus, and the Holy Ghost was a wellspring springing. Hallelujah. And but the reality of it is, as I have a wellspring springing all the time, it's an artesian. You know, an artesian that doesn't produce all the time, you can't count on it. I have an artesian right now that is flowing about 36 to 37 gallons per minute. It stays at a constant temperature 365 days a year, 24 hours a day, and I have it supplying a raceway for fish so that I can grow fish and maintain a whole bunch of other life. If that thing shut off for an hour, everything's dead. for the, as far as the fish go, because they're trout. They'll all die in an hour. They're dead. Huh? And of course, if it's shut off for a couple of days, all the rest of the stuff, it would be dead, especially in the heat of the summer. Are you listening to me? You know, come on, talk to me about understanding a relationship with God where you have a continual supply of the Holy Ghost, that you have a continual supply of all that you need. And then you talk to the water, you talk to the rock, the water comes out, you receive a continuous, ongoing feeling of infilling, not F-E-E-L. I want to get this right, but F-I-L-L. It's one of the problems with the English language. Right? We say feel and people think F-E-E-L. No, we didn't say feel. We said F-I-L-L. Feel. Not feel. 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 To continually be filled. Hallelujah. Not to be continually felt, but to continually be filled. Ha ha ha. Hallelujah. The Nambon Brazezea has a fedoromande, has a fedenamboki, has a fideste prasu. It has a feeling. Huh? It has a divine expression. Huh? It has overwhelming glory external to you. It has an outworking. Hallelujah. Praise God for that. But it doesn't start that way. It starts in a realm of just of this relationship, which really I make faith and relationship equal. I don't make them non-equal. I don't even make them proportional. I make them equal. Huh? I don't make them proportional. I mean, as X increases, Y increases. I make them equal. Hallelujah. Totally, purely equal. Somebody said, well, there's not a lot of difference between proportion and equal. Well, listen, just understand, I'm making them one, equal, okay? Yeah. Are you listening to me? Yeah. Why, how do I do that? Because I live by the Word and not by my thinking realm, not by my experience realm, not by, you know, the things that are maybe even being imposed upon me, by my sleepy body, my tired body, my hungry body. I found a place where I can talk to the Lord and say, Lord, do you want me to fast? And hear the Lord speak to me about fasting and know that I will have a divine fast and I won't be hungry. Huh? Hallelujah. And afterwards, he was hungry. After 40 years, 40 days, he was hungry. After 40 days, he was hungry. And afterwards, he was hungry. Hallelujah. I want you to learn how to begin to live by the Word. You want to walk in the Spirit and live by the Holy Ghost? You're going to have to learn to live by the Word. And you know what? You're going to hear a lot about the Word. So God's going to say things to you about the Word. You're not going to do them. I said, you're not going to do them. And so I said, how can you say it? Because I watch you. You don't do them. You face up against something you don't like or it isn't fashionable or it doesn't fit into your schedule and you don't do it. And guess what? You're stuck. The Lord said, don't worry about it. You can skip that one. It wasn't really that bit important anyways. I just put it in there because I thought, you know, some people really need this. But are you listening to me?
Yes.
Hey, you know, we're gonna build your house and leave a couple of blocks out. That ain't going to work out for you, man. That house is coming down in the first storm. We're building on a foundation. Everything has to be laid in order around the cornerstone. Everything, every living stone set in its proper place so that you may be built up a holy sanctuary, a holy house, to be able to offer up the praise that is acceptable to God by Christ Jesus. All the time being authorized. All the time being certified, authorized, and given the authority. Huh? I don't believe in a process of sanctification. That means I must believe in a process of being saved. That must mean I must believe in a process of being acceptable to God. Because nothing that is not, anything that is not sanctified is not acceptable to God. He will not interact with it. From Genesis chapter 28 all the way through the end of the Bible, Revelation 22, 21. Listen to me. I can't help it that philosophical ideologies and traditions of men trying to come in and contaminate and pollute the Word of God. They, you know what God did? He watched over His Word and He made sure that not one of their thoughts became a verse in His Bible. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, well, I need the sage to interpret the Bible because it's beyond me. You don't need no stinking sage. Hallelujah. You got the Holy Ghost. Praise God. You got the grand interpreter. You got the one who makes known. Hallelujah. Right?
Yes.
Bernie, it's good to see you. I said that for Bernie. You know, the Jewish background is you just basically, you gotta depend on somebody else to tell you what the Word of God means, and you never spend any time with the Word. It's just all the Talmud. And instead of the Torah, it's the Talmud. And so look, instead of the Bible, it's somebody else's interpretation. The Christian community does the same thing. Does the same thing.
Yes, that's true.
Mm. I want to get you over here in a place of contending for the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. A faith where you and I became a new creation, a new creature, belonging completely to God, being one with Christ Jesus, being brought into the family of God, being filled with the Holy Ghost, having the Holy Ghost as our teacher, having Christ Jesus birthed on the inside of us. Birthed, born, conceived. That's why Paul said, must I travail in birth again for you until Christ be formed in you? Who is the new man? It's Christ in me. Who is the new creation? It's the greater one who lives on the inside of me. Hallelujah. What is the new spirit? What is the new heart? Come on. It's the reproduction of Christ Jesus. Unless a seed be sown in the earth and die, it abides alone. But when it dies, it'll bring forth much fruit. And God's law is that everything brings forth after its own kind. And I'm after his kind. And you're after his kind. And that is the faith. That is the faith. Somebody said, well, I'm not Jesus. Well, you know what? I understand what you're trying to say, that you're not Jesus. But you better recognize that you're in him and that you no longer live and that your life is all about him. And that you don't exist outside of him. No existe. For somebody who doesn't only español solamente. No existe outside of Jesus. You listening to me?
Yes.
How is it then that you give yourself to the development of this wonderful blessing that God has given us when he gave us the gift of holiness and he gave us the gift of righteousness and he gave us the authority to be sons of God? And I think that when in interacting with people, of God's people, and I want them to define for me, tell me, what is a son of God? And now tell me, what is the authorization? If you've been authorized, you have the authority. That means you've been authorized and given the authority to be a son of God. What does that allow you to do? Speak to me. Because I see a lot of confusion. And then what I watch this breakdown go from, you know, trying to give me some words of truth from the Bible, quoting a few scriptures, and then it begins to be integrated with all kinds of experience and the buts and the ifs and the why fors and the what fors. And it just demolishes the faith that was once delivered unto the saints, their ability now to actually produce the miracle. The miracle is produced by the Word of God and by the Spirit of God. And it's got to be exactly what the Word of God says and exactly what the Holy Ghost is doing. Otherwise, it won't be produced. I'm going to tell you right now, it's easy to understand the authority of the Son of God. Look at Jesus. Hallelujah. Did Jesus give you his earthly ministry only? Two heads shaking no, five smiles, three heads shaking no, 20 smiles, five sour looks, and a whole host of people that don't know. I mean, you know what I'm saying? You know, no, he gave us his heavenly ministry too. We're seated with him in a heavenly realm. He's exalted far above all principality and power and might and dominion, every name that is named in this world, and not only in this world to come, but not only in this world, but also in the world to come, and you and I are seated together with him. That is hard to wrap your head around. And you're never going to unless you find a place to have the Spirit of the living God minister to you, nurture you, mature you, grow you up. The Word of God minister to you, nurture you, mature you, grow you up.
Amen.
That's why we have church meeting. Because most of what God's going to do, he has restricted it to right here. And that pops a lot of people's bubbles. And that messes a lot of people's theology up. Father placed in the church, in the midst of the church. This is where it's developed. This is where it grows. This is where it matures. This is where it's sent out from. Ask Paul. An abundance of revelation, 3 years. Then he goes, submits himself to the local church, 14 years. Labors in the church. Makes tents, has a business going, laboring in the church, has more spirit knowledge, more revelation knowledge than anybody on the planet. Hello. Until the church says, by the Holy Ghost, says to the church leaders, separate unto me Paul and Barnabas for the work whereunto I have called them. And after that, they fasted and prayed. My goodness, what a different kind of culture. Now, that's not a Western civilization. That's a different kind of culture. That's not the idea of the church in the context of the Western civilization, because the church has actually been changed by the Western civilization. Ultimately, it came under Antiochus Epiphanes IV that he wanted to so advance the Greek ideology. He wanted everybody to be conformed to that which Alexander the Great espoused, that if he found anybody with a Bible or circumcised, you were killed. You were killed. You were destroyed. Because everybody had to conform to the Greek way and bow to the Greek God. And if you were circumcised or if you had any portion of the Bible, that means you weren't conforming and you were killed. And that is an expression of demonic power. Listen to me. That is not just an expression of a tyrant. Listen to me. Ask questions at home. That is a tyrant that expresses the tyrannical reign of Satan that has influence right now, at this moment. Listen to me. I'm not so much interested in just history as history stands all alone trying to figure out what this and that thing and the other thing is. I'm interested in just looking that much more and understanding and not being ignorant concerning Satan's devices, because I know he's not changed his attack. He's coming at you and he's coming at me and he's coming at the church, and we're going to have to learn how to be fortified. And many times when we understand the attack, we're able to more appreciate, the means by which to counterattack, or really the means by which to stand in God and not to be subject to the attack, really, better said. Listen, dear people, the church is going to have to come over into what God has purposed the church to be. The church is supposed to be the very expression of the written word. How are we going to be the expression of the written word? Because we're going to live in the living word. Huh? You're not going to separate the living word from the written word. And the thing about it is God is, listen to me. We've been born of the incorruptible seed by the word of God. We've been born of an incorruptible seed by the word of God, which lives and abides forever. We're the issue of that. We're the reproduction of that. You can't say you're born of it and you're not the reproduction of it. Huh? You weren't a recip for an embryo. You know what I'm saying? For a genetically distinct clone. Are you listening to me? That has no genetic relationship. That's something we can do. We can manipulate stuff right now. We do that out on the ranch. We manipulate stuff because, there's no problem with it. But listen, you and I, that's not who we are. We are reproduction of exactly what the seed was that was sown to produce us. We are living word. Hallelujah. Living stones. Hallelujah. He's the cornerstone. We the living stones. We living stones, living words, see more, seek more, hunger more. Are you with me? Thirst more? Yes. No, you're okay right now, but you're going to get in tomorrow, and your tomorrow is going to be all about what it is you do. What are you? Oh, I'm a mechanic. Oh, what are you? I'm a garbage man. Oh, what are you? Well, I'm a lawyer. Now you're going to really get big on us. Oh, what are you? Oh, I'm a doctor. What are you? I'm a teacher. That's who you are? What a life. Isn't that miserable? Oh, no. I make $75,000 a year. You do. That stinks. That's your world? Oh, yeah. And I live in suburbia, and I got a 3-bedroom home, and we just got new furniture. Whoopie-doo. What is that what you define your life to be? Is that your sum existence? You cannot serve God and mammon. You'll hate God. You serve mammon, you'll hate God. You find your identity in mammon, you'll hate God. Problem is, people don't want to go with hate and love. They want to go with like. God don't have no like. Don't like doesn't exist. It's hate or love. It's passion. It's truth. People want to run and hide. They disobey God, and they hear his voice, and they want to run and hide, and they want to make believe that nothing's changed. They want to sew fig leaves together. That's really bad thinking. How long does a fig leaf clothing work? I mean, think about it. I mean, goodness gracious, how long did it take to sew them things together in the first place? And then they're going to be like all withered away in 2 days. It's falling off of you. That's the best man can do. try to do a cover up and then run and hide in fear and shame. People are always running and hide in fear and shame when the word goes forth. They feel bad about themselves. They're running, hiding in fear, shame. They feel like they don't measure up. They run and hide in fear and shame. Instead of allowing the Spirit of the Lord to begin to work in them, a resolve and a surrender, they run and hide in fear and shame. Pride makes them run and hide in fear and shame because they don't measure up. Huh? No, you come to the one that supplies to you and I the ability to be everything that's holy and acceptable. And when we see the things that are deficient in our life and are lacking in our life, we come to the rock that's higher than us. I'm going to sit there and process, and I got plan. It's time for plan B to kick in now. No, it's time for you to get with plan A and start laboring right and start doing it right and stop fashioning yourself after a man and just listen to what anybody's got to say, including me. If you cannot validate and verify everything I'm saying in the Word of God, you erase what I say. Because it's God's Word that is going to make you stand. It's God's Word that is going to bring you prosperity. It's God's Word that the Holy Ghost is going to lead you into and show you how to walk this thing out. No shortcuts. We need to contend for the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. And it ain't all about finances either, because I'm going to tell you right now, there's people on the mission field right now, they have having food and clothing, therewith they are content. Hallelujah. And I'm going to tell you right now, wait till you see what they're going to be looking like when they get home. Wait till you see the pile of riches that have mounted up throughout the ages on their behalf. Think about it, people. Hello. Listen, lust demands instantaneous gratification. It's so sad as I watch people make lust bigger than love over and over again on so many different levels, even on the natural level. Watching people make lust bigger than love. Come on, people. Jesus said, if you love me, you'll do what I say. If you love me, you'll keep my words. If you love me, you'll believe. Who's going to believe his report? Who's going to believe the report that we've been given the authority? As many as received him. Have you received him? Yes. Today I'm asking you, those that are here in this place, those that are watching on the web, have you received Christ Jesus? If you've received him, he's given you the authority to become sons of God. A miracle took place in the anointing. You were anointed. More than having oil poured out upon an altar, the Holy Ghost was poured out upon you, and you became the divine meeting place where man can commune with God. Hallelujah. A place, people talk about portal. I'm one. And everybody else who's been born of the Spirit, you a portal. You're a portal of glory. Hallelujah. God, the Holy Ghost lives on the inside of you. My goodness, angels ascending and descending. I mean, come on, people. If we'll get our eyes open, we'll realize there's more with us than are with them. If you just let the Spirit of wisdom and revelation take hold of you, you get more ignorant every day, occupying yourself with the world. You become more blind every day as you give in to all your ideas and those things that men's fortunes would teach them. Listen to me. There's only one place of being able to see, and God wants you to see more. There's only one place of knowledge and understanding and wisdom. And God says, seek it, and then you'll find the knowledge of the holy. Then you'll find and understand the fear of the Lord, which is very important, Father, to be in awe of God. You get in awe of God, the relationship, it's a relationship magnet that just draws you in. You're like, woo, you amazing God. I'm just going to stand here and gaze at you, Lord. I don't want to do anything. He said, no, you got to go do something. No. I don't like you. Are you going with me? Moses standing on a rock in the middle of a wilderness saying, Father, I don't want no land that flows with milk and honey. I don't want no wells and houses and vineyards. I want you. I'd rather be right here on this rock in the desert with you and have all those riches and all that wealth and all that provision. I'm not going anywhere unless you're going with me. You tell me you're going with me and I'll go. And God says, I'll go with you. He says, okay, let's do it then. Hallelujah. I mean, come on, Satanaya. Huh? He stayed in church. Joshua, think about him. He stayed in church. He saw the glory and he stayed at the church. He stayed right at the door of the tabernacle, right there where Jesus is. He stayed right there at the door of the tabernacle. He would not depart. Hallelujah. What happened? He began to grow and mature in the realms of spirit knowledge to the point in time where all of a sudden God said, now I want you to take him and I want you to lay a hand upon him, because now the anointing, this ability to now receive an authority, a divine power, is transferred for the first time through the laying on of hands and not just by the anointing oil. And now he steps into a glory that is nothing compared to what Father has for you. And I said, it's nothing. It's nothing. It was a measure. That's why I say it's nothing compared. It was glory. It was beautiful. It was heavenly. But it's nothing compared to what God has for us. The baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire. There has to be another revival, a moving forward in God of the baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire, because we don't know what it is. It was just like, it was as though, you know, in 1906 with Pop Seymour in September, in April, rather, April 9th, 1906, there was a revival of Pentecost, and it's like everybody just stayed there at the entryway, at the door. No, we receive this so we can begin to glow with a glory glow, and our shadow passing over men, begin to heal them. There is going on with Christ Jesus. There's going on with the Word. There's a maturing in Christ Jesus. There's a maturing in the Word of God. We're going to have to contend for the faith that was once delivered unto the saints. We're going to have to contend. We're going to have to contend. You're going to have to get in the fight. Yes. Leave your work to just a few. Get it. Get up. Yes. Get up. Amen. Get up. Amen. Hello. Get up in Jesus' name. Yes. Get up in Jesus' name. You make the house of God first. Yes. You make the things of the Spirit first. Because otherwise you're going to grow old and cantankerous, and all you're going to have is the devil's going to throw you a little bone to chew on, make you satisfied a little bit. When you're missing out on sitting at the banqueting table with the mighty. Come on, man. What do you want? Where's your heart? Where's your passions? Where's your vision? Are you living for a temporal life? Are you pursuing something that lasts forever? Are you a stranger and a pilgrim who's willing rather to dwell in tents that you might keep your heart right, recognizing that you're seeking a kingdom that is to come? It's builder and maker is God. It's the faith realm. Listen to me. I'm bound to say case to pretty effort. Somebody said, how do I balance it? You don't. It's total abandonment. It's total abandonment. But you want to abandon yourself to the right way. Not to just, okay, we're going to kind of touchy-feely our way through this. We think that this is right. Come on, people, let's do it God's way. There's a discipline in the things of the Spirit. There is a right way. He teaches us the right way. So that we don't have to go through so much hardship, so many problems, so many ups and downs. I've been in the church all of my life. I mean, being a preacher's kid, I mean, my goodness, I've had an inside view all my life. People come to me and they want to be an evangelist. I got a whole bunch of different things to say about them than most people do. Why? Because I'm the son of an evangelist and I went through the hard knocks and I realized from heaven that there was things being done and nothing to do with God's wisdom. Yes. And it created problems. There's about preparing to go. There's a preparation to go. God wants us to be prepared on every work. I can go down the list of so many things that we do, and we do it in an honest and a good and sincere heart, but we're just wrong. It's just wrong. And you try to tell people, and then they don't want to listen to you because, people, all of a sudden they believe it. They make it all touchy-feely. Somehow I got more anointing than you got. My anointing is bigger than your anointing. That's nonsense. You may have an expression of the anointing that has grown and matured in one area. You know, I've always been amazed at David Hogan, how he's had an anointing mature in an area of raising the dead. I mean, you know, that's an amazing. Or someone over here, they got an anointing that has matured in, casting out devils. I mean, I love being with Carlos. He's going to come sometime this year here. Praise God. My dear friend. And it's amazing. I mean, If he gets within 30 foot of a person who's got a devil, the demon goes out. I mean, it's just an amazing thing. I mean, he's matured in certain areas of functioning in the authority of a son of God. I don't remember if we were in Argentina or whether we were in Brazil or somewhere in South America, and we had a bunch of equipment with us, cameras and such, and other things. musical instruments. And the immigration, it was Brazil, immigration. They said, no, we got to keep it. You don't have the proper paperwork on it. And it's going to take, you'll be able to get it within the next, 30 days. They came out, I was sitting in the van with Carlos, and they come out and told Carlos, and he said, and he screamed out, in nombre de Jesucristo. See, as many as received, he gave them the authority, even to those who believe on the power of his name. Huh? Even those who believe on his name. Something happens with his name. Go read about everything that happens with his name. They that call upon the name of the Lord shall be delivered. The Messiah anointing will begin to work for you right there. The deliverance, it'll drive out the foreigners, it'll drive out the aliens, it'll drive out the enemies, it'll drive out everything that tries to, it'll drive out all darkness, all sin, all iniquity. Come on, think about it.
Hallelujah.
And I'm going to tell you right now, I promise you, inside of 10 minutes, immigration had a parade coming with all of the stuff to the van and unloading it. Just authority. Suddenly they had a big change of mind. Hallelujah. I found a lot of times where that authority works in different ways. I was in a situation the other day, and I got up to the counter of the people who make the decisions in the planning department. As soon as I started talking, the person was really grumpy and aggravated. They said, there's no way this can happen. It's going to take, months. No, we got to go through this review and that review. I said, oh, okay, no problem. Just checking, just staying in the anointing, okay? How are you doing today? Bless you. And then she comes back within 5 minutes. Oh, yeah, we could do this over the counter right now. Yeah, because the anointing, you stay in the expression of divine power and the virtue of heaven. People have never been willing to learn about the Son of meekness and lowliness. He said, you want to learn how the anointing works? Then you're going to have to come here and learn about meekness and lowliness. Oh, we want to do it another way. Well, it's working over here another way, a little bit of an expression. As soon as there's a little bit of expression of an anointing, a little bit above what's normal in the church, suddenly we say, this is revival. This is the full manifestation of power of God. Give me a break. God is calling you and I to come and learn from Him, not so much from each other. There are things that we can learn from each other, but it's always got to be defined and kept within the context of the Word. He says, come and learn. I want to show you how this functions. I want to show you how my rest works. I want to show you how my authority works. Come and learn of me. I'm meek and lowly. Hallelujah. Come take my yoke. He's got a great yoke. Look at His yoke. Look at His wonderful authority that He has as a servant of the living God. He's calling us. He says, come learn of me. He shows us. He said, let me show you how the anointing works. Sit down. I'm going to wash all your feet. I'm going to take the towel and you're not washing my feet. Because here's what Peter's thinking. If he washed my feet, I'm going to have to wash their feet. There ain't no way I'm doing that. Basically, that's how it's going down. There's no way, we draw all our identity from you and you're the best, the most. And he was. And if I'm going to have to start drawing my identity from a foot washer, this is going to be a serious demotion. Are you listening to me? He said, well, then you have no part in me if I don't wash your feet. Peter finally gets in and says, wash me every bit from my head to my toe. He said, no, your feet, having your feet washed makes you totally clean. Hallelujah. We used to try to do it. We used to have foot washing services. They were phasing out when I was a little guy. I mean, they started phasing out at 5 years old. By the time I was 12, I couldn't find a foot washing service in America. Pentecost had drifted that far. Nobody wants to hear about washing somebody's stinky feet. We're just looking for another motivational speaker to tell us how good we are, how much we're succeeding, how happy we are, to give us some more, of that positive thinking by that backslidden Methodist preacher, Norman Vincent Peale. I guess only one person knows who I'm talking about. Two people. Trump. His pastor, who he didn't have a pastor. Jesus was his pastor. Boy, he really got demoted. Then he went to Norman Vincent Peale. Well, God told us, I'm just going to stop here for just a minute. Ha! God told us that the only people that we're supposed to be a part of is seeing the righteous rule.
Yes.
Only the right, we're supposed to vote for the righteous.
Yes.
Oh, no, we got to all participate. Well, what if we just stopped participating? And started ordering and commanding. What if we took our place of authority? What if we suddenly believed that whatever I bind on earth my associate. Amen?
Yes.
My partner. Huh? My co-inheritor. Uh-oh. We'd bide in heaven. And whatever I loosed or released upon, what kind of say? You got to grow in this. You're going to have to go up against a fortified opposition, satanic opposition. Says there's no way you're having this authority. We're here to stop you. And then you look at it and you start walking towards such a troop and you go, ooh. That's scary. I tried and I got knocked down. They shot off one of the cannons and it hit over about a mile away from me and I fell down. And I ran for the hills because it doesn't look like my war. This doesn't look like peace and rest and joy. Now this is the war. This is the battle. This is the breaking through. This is being a restorer of the breach. This is being a person who's going to chop a new way, as it were, huh? The dweller of the paths, a person who's going to open up the headway so that people can once again dwell within the paths of righteousness that have been overgrown, huh? With all of the stuff, because nobody's been on the path lately. Are you listening to me? I'm not going to stop. I'm going to stand here, and I'm going to, on the highest ground that's possible, highest ground of God's word, I'm going to declare what God has said. It may be too, you see what theologians do, they go, there is no way we have that kind of authority. Thus, it must mean something else. And then they espouse all what they think it means, because we certainly can't have an authority to bind on earth, because I tried it one time, it didn't work. I guarantee you, people, it's going to be more than trying it one time. It's taking a stand of faith and growing and maturing in it. Huh? People give themselves to school. For how? Somebody told me the other day, this is how I feel like giving up. I said, you feel like giving up? I said, the only person that has a right to give up is God. He's the one who's getting the bad end of the deal here. You're going to give up. Well, you give me a break. Huh? Hello. How long have you been in school now? Oh, 18 years. Well, why have you given up? You've been 18 years in school to try to be what it is you have a vision to be. And now you've been here, what, 18 months and you're ready to give up? Give me a break. Wrong thinking, huh? Wrong value system, huh? God wants to reorder our value system. What's important to us? What's meaningful? What's true riches? What is true riches? When you hear that Christ was rich, what do you think of? A whole stack of hundreds? Huh? Do you think of a Fort Knox plus full of gold? Rich. Rubies, diamonds, wealth, trillions, whatever. When you say, he who was rich, what kind of riches did he have? Became poor for our sake. What does his poverty look like then? So that through his poverty, I might be made rich. Well, if I don't know what his riches were and the poverty that he took on, I'm never going to understand my promotion from poverty to riches. I'm never going to understand what it means to be poor. I'm never going to understand what the Lord, what kind of poor people God wants me to go deal with. Because we go do a philanthropy thing. We go hand out some soup and some bread and say, praise God, we did our duty. No, we need to think about what true riches are. We need to think about being blessed with all spiritual blessings, what spiritual blessings are in a heavenly realm, because you're in a heavenly realm. You got to start thinking about being heavenly people instead of earthly ones. Amen. People of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Huh? Amen. Instead of people that belong to the mere race of humanity. That's what Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 3. You behave as mere men. You just behave as mere men. With all of your choices, and I'm of Apollos, and I'm of Peter, I'm of Paul. None of them died for you. All your strife and all your choices makes you act and behave as nothing more than mere men. Mm-mm-mm. Come on, people. We in Christ Jesus, we no longer live. Come on, people. Come on. Why sit on the sideline? Why sit on the sideline instead of pressing in? Why I'm going to tell you right now, believe you me, I am so desperate to be used by the Lord. I am so desperate to grow and mature into what He has for me. I mean, I don't even feel like I've begun, but I don't feel like I've even begun to scratch the surface of what He has. And I'm going to do it. I'm going to go passionately after these things. We are going to contend, which means to wrestle. It's what Jacob did. Huh?
Yes.
He grabbed a hold of God and said, I'm not letting you go. Yes. Let me go. No. I'm not letting you go. Why don't you come to the meeting and see a big wrestling match going on.
Amen.
See everybody wrestling with the Lord. Laid hold on God. To just begin to agree with Him like never before, to say, well, wait a minute, okay, these things are available. Now, how am I going to give myself to growing and maturing in them? How am I going to give myself to seeing that which Father's purpose for me to be produced within my life? Because that's what it's all about. It's a gift. It's come to you. But there's a reciprocation of it. You are given a gift of holiness to learn how to walk in holiness. You are given a gift of righteousness to learn how to walk in righteousness. You are given the authority of a son to mature into the fullness of the measure, the maturity of the ministry of Jesus, even unto a fully matured man. God gave you the wonderful expressions of love so that you can know the love of Christ which passes knowledge and be filled with all the fullness of God. Come on. Now unto him who is able to do superabundantly above all that you think or ask, according to the power that is in heaven that you're trying to pray down. Let me go ahead and give it to you one more time. Okay. Now, unto him is able to do superabundantly above all that you can think or ask, according to the power that is in heaven that you can go after praying down.
No.
Well, why don't I just start? I'm going to start quoting the scripture the way everybody reads it, lives it rather than reads it. Huh? Now unto him is able to do superly abundantly above all that you can think or ask, according to the power that is in heaven that you can pray down and believe for one day to come to pass. Always longing for but cannot have. You're going to have to recognize that somebody lives on inside of you. You're going to have to recognize that you've been sanctified and authorized and given authority, and there's a power and a glory, that there's a greater one on the inside of you. Are you saying that you can defeat Satan at every point? Yeah, because the greater one lives on the inside of me. And when I yield to him, I mean, it's all about him. It's what he does. I can do nothing without him. And besides that, I don't even want to do anything without him, because it's a dud. I mean, you know, it's like saying, I've got the most spectacular fireworks you've ever seen in your life. This is going to blow you away. And everybody's standing around like going, wow, this is going to be amazing. And then you light the thing and it goes, poof. And everybody walks around with that expression right there. And that was the glory of God. And that was the power and display of heaven. Come on, people, we're going to have to quit living like that. There is a nambete yashahai. There is an explosion of divine power and authority that you and I are going to have to pay a price to function in. You and I are going to have to be willing to be completely consecrated or segregated or separated unto. Hallelujah. I want you to stand with me. Because I'll just keep talking about these things till it gets dark, and then we can just go through till the next day. The sun will come up right around there. Hallelujah. I'm asking you today, would you let God have His way? I'm asking you today, would you be conformed to the image of the Son? I'm asking you today, would you go ahead and take hold of that which has already begun? You know, Paul said you're not like a child that differs nothing from a servant. You're not under tutors anymore. No, you've been made fully matured sons. You've been given the ability and the sense now to do Father's work. That's what He said, you heirs of God, co-inheritors with Christ Jesus. A gift that we now have got to begin to be persuaded of. And we've got to come up against the challenge and laugh at the challenge and smack it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Father, I give you so much power. Let me just tell you this, because I love bragging on the Holy Ghost. The other night we were in a strange place and I laid down in a strange bed and I no sooner fell off to sleep and a demon power was hovering over my face and I just went like that. And the place was clean. It was clean. I did do that and say in Jesus' name. Smack, because I live in an authority. I praise God for the people like Carlos Anacondia who's shown great authority in casting out devils. And there's a list that have gone on with them, and Derek Prince and Don Bastian and so many other people. And I praise God for all the folks that are working miracles and the various different displays of the anointing and the beautiful splendor of it all, because it's got so many sparkles to it and so much splendor to it. I mean, I don't tire of any expression of the anointing. But Father's still got so much more. You're going to have to receive a power on the inside of you, and it's got to be more riches to you. It's got to be a treasure in this earthen vessel from which you then go and get all that you have need of. There is a supply on the inside of me. There is a provision. The anointing is always shown. The one who is anointed couldn't be killed. That's what David was saying. How is Saul fallen as one who had never been anointed? How is his shield broken down as weapons of war perish, as though they had never been anointed because there was an invincibility upon it? The anointed of the Lord protected, the anointed of the Lord with great divine provision. Come now. If you need to regroup, regroup. Come now. You better define the value of your life. And I'm going to challenge you today. You better define it in Christ Jesus, because if you don't define the meaning, the value of your life in Christ Jesus, you're forever lost. I don't care what you've done. I don't care who you are. I don't care what things you believe. Until the life of Christ Jesus is all that you desire, there's something wrong with your heart. The fruits of the Spirit of the Son crying, Abba, Father, are very definite, very distinct. They long for the things of the Father's will being done in their life. Nothing else matters. Put me upon the altar of sacrifice. Pour me out like a drink offering. I want my life and the challenges that I face to be nothing more than a witness and a praise and expression that says, Father, you're all I want. Your salvation's all I desire. Whether I live or whether I die, we'll do all that you say to do. Listen to me. That's what brought God's people into the inheritance that he planned for them. A generation that stood up. And I see the millennials are coming. I see, and somebody said, oh, the millennials think they're special. They are. They're special. They're coming with Holy Ghost and power. They're coming. I'm going to tell you right now, if your children aren't involved in what Ruth Ann is leading in the youth ministry, you're keeping them out of moving forward with God. Because there's a special anointing. There's right now, God's moving by his Spirit throughout the earth, where people are hungry and thirsty for him. I'm telling you, the millennials are coming. They are special. They are radical. They're not settling out for second best. They're tired of the status quo. They're going to have it the way God described it. They're going to say like the children of Israel, whether we live or whether we die, we're going to do everything you said to do. They took a hold of, recite the word day and night, that you may observe everything that was spoken and written. Then shall you make your way prosper. Then shall you have good success. We're talking about divine, heavenly, eternal prosperity, doing the will of the Father. Father said, you don't do my will, you don't belong to me. Father's will is very clearly defined. His will is not for you to get a career and make money. He doesn't say that anywhere. His will is for you to deny yourself, take up your cross, and follow him. His will is for you to start with the one person that's right beside of you in Jerusalem, the one person, your family member, the person that's right next to you, the house next to you, the person that's right across the street, your neighborhood. Come on, people. The devil, the powers of darkness say nobody in your neighborhood wants to hear. It says no soliciting. I tell you, there are people out walking your street all the time. Come on, you listen to me. That's what God's commanded us. But we get involved in other things and it will shut down the voice. The earthly concerns, the voices of the earthly concerns will become so loud that the voice of heaven cannot be heard. The interest and the passion and the desire for earthly things will become so demanding that you'll no longer feel the passions and the desires of heaven upon your soul. And for many people, the anointing has departed and they did not know it or realize it. What a terrible thing. What a terrible thing. You can pray with David, restore unto me the joy of your salvation. Renew a right heart in me. I want to get this right, Father. I've made wrong choices. I've made wrong decisions. I've not known how to stand in the glory. I've not known how to stand in the anointing. I've not known how to live by the things that you have given and provided for me is in relationship to a wellspring springing of your very life and rivers flowing. But Father, today, I'm determined. If it costs me everything, it costs me my life. Everything. My wife and I take everything that we have and we lay upon the altar and say, Father, we want none of it. We want you. You take it. It's all yours. It's all yours. Send us. Send us. I'll go anywhere. Father, I'll go anywhere. The Father told me today to go camp out in the mountains of the Himalayas and the mountains of Afghanistan or Tajikistan or some unreached people groups, places where people have never heard. I'm gone. We're gone. We're there. We're done. Somebody said, aren't you going to raise the support? I don't need to raise the support. He'll feed me from the ravens, if nothing else. I'll eat from the king's table. I'm dead. My life is hid into the very purpose and identity and call of God as it is expressed in Christ Jesus. And that's what you signed up for. And that's the covenant. You can't break the covenant and say you're in it. You can't break the covenant. It nullifies it. You can't say you've got the gift of holiness when you've not been willing to be taught holiness. You cannot say you have the gift of righteousness when you've not been willing to learn righteousness. You nullified the covenant. The covenant was, I give my life in exchange for your life. That's the covenant. Now you want to have his life and hold on to your life? You nullified the covenant. You nullified the covenant. People won't deal honestly with themselves. I find it over and again. People are in a backslidden state, in a lukewarm state. You're sliding back. You're drifting. You have no place of understanding. You have no realm to orient yourself. Only a person who's been standing in the place of the glory of God can recognize you drifting. You're drifting. One of the first things we learned in surfing and sailing was find landmarks, especially surfing when there's big waves. The current carry you so quickly. You won't be able to, you can't even keep up with it. You've got to constantly paddle or you've got to have a landmark. People have lost their landmark. They drifted way out. Drift way out to sea. Get caught in the current, just stick your way on out. I've been out in big surf looking around, see somebody way out, drifting out. See them paddling, they not recognize they can't get in. Go out. Give them my leash and paddle them in. Many respects, that's what I'm doing right now for some of you. You think you're right, you're not. Your fruits show it. Every tree is known by its fruit. Is it the life of Jesus? Is it the life of Christ? Is it what God describes in his word? Are you contending for the faith that was once delivered unto the saints? Are you pressing in? Will anybody ever be saved by the way that you live your life? Will the church go on by your commitments to him? Would there be a witness in the community of San Diego if it was left up to you? You got to deal with these things. Those of you watching me by web right now, and you're in San Diego County right now, especially I'm talking to you. People don't want the truth. They just want to go hide in a bigger church where nobody's going to make them responsible for the way they live in their life. I'm telling you right now, I'm not selling out for nothing. I'm going to speak these words which he's put in my mouth. I'm not going to diminish aught from it. That which he said. Not one tittle, not one tot, not tittle or jot. People, God's calling you, and it demands change. You better start rearranging your schedule. Because Father beholds, lo, there's not a word in your mouth and your tongue, but Father knows it, recognizes it all together. He searches the hearts. He searches all the parts of your being. Let the floodlight of heaven shine upon your soul right now. Let God be able to see all the things that you grabbed a hold of for yourself. And now you begin to abhor it and you let it go. And you get right with God right now in the name of Jesus. Get right with God. Jesus is coming. Purify yourself. Jesus is coming. Separate yourself. Jesus is coming. He looks upon your heart. Where's your heart? Where are your desires? What do you want? You cannot serve God and mammon both. You'll hate God. You're going to serve mammon. Walk with God. Press in. Learn how to do it right. Get counsel. Get guidance. Get insight. Father will take care of you. He'll provide for you. But I'm going to tell you right now, you ought to be of a heart and a mind that if you had to live in sackcloth and ashes and live as the poorest person on the planet, still you would not compromise nor trade one day. For the glory of His presence. For what He did for us at Calvary. He called you and me to come and pick up a cross. He called us to come and take up a cross. His cross has called us to come and follow Him. There's no other way. There's one way. It's narrow. It's a cross. It's a cross. It's denying yourself. What will you do? Don't you get caught up in the pollutions of this world, the value system of this world. There's greater riches, spiritual riches. There's a heavenly realm for a heavenly people filled with the glorious things of heaven, the power of the Holy Ghost, the very person and life of Jesus. What will you do? In Jesus' name. Every yoke broken. In Jesus' name. Every false way removed. In Jesus' name. Change comes to every heart in this place. Father's dealing with many people in this place right now. You know the Holy Ghost is dealing with you. And it's time to get a breakthrough. Some of you have drifted. Some of you have made wrong agreements. It's time for you to get a breakthrough. Maybe there's people here today. You've never called upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, He's here to save you and change you. He's here to work a miracle. It's all vested in the power of the utterance of His name. The Holy Ghost will come upon you and everything will begin new in Him. Right now, God is calling you, and especially I hear the Spirit of the Lord calling and just out to people who've created values for themselves within a worldly framework at the expense of pursuing the heavenly vision and the heavenly call. Today, right now, you get right. Right now, today is your opportunity to get right. Some of you are bound in this decision that you've made. You're bound. You've been tied. Your hands are tied. You've been led away prisoner and captive. We're not going to stand by as you put into the prison. We come to rescue you. It's time for you to rededicate your life and reconsecrate your life today. And I want you to come in an act of rededication. And those of you that God has been dealing with, that the Spirit of the Lord has been talking to, and you know you put things, priorities in your life that are wrong. You deprioritize the kingdom. You can't say the kingdom of God is first. God is calling you. God is calling you. God the Holy Ghost is calling you. God is calling you. God the Holy Spirit is dealing with your heart. You get your priorities right. Don't you stand around and try to think it through. You just surrender. It's about total abandonment. God's calling you. There's some of you that God is calling in this place. Do not hesitate. Because I'm going to tell you something's going on bigger here than just me and you. Father's in the midst of this call. Father's in the midst of this sermon. Father's in the midst of the response of the heart of every person in this place. Father's here. This is about your response to Father, not to man. This is about the dedication of your life and say, wait a minute, Father, I have reevaluated things in my life and I'm not reevaluated them based upon that which you purposed and caused a greater response to that call that you've made. But I'd rather rearrange my life to fit and suit me. God is calling you. God the Holy Ghost is calling you. It's nothing to do with men. Father's ready to bless you. One of my best friends, one of my dear friends, who was all about the kingdom of God in every way, he died of a heart attack, a massive heart attack. There was no getting him to the hospital. No one ever thought that a 58-year-old man was going to, was so much going on in the kingdom, was so, I mean, so many things would be taken from this earth so quickly. I'm just saying that because, people, you don't know how long you've got yet to labor for him. Let us labor for the master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us sacrifice our life upon the altar of his grace, upon the altar that was given at Calvary's cross. Let us hold on to nothing. Let us stand before him with all boldness, saying, I held on to nothing. I held nothing back from me. It's all for you, Lord. Whether we live or whether we die, we're yours. We're doing it your way, oh God. As you described it, we're going to contend for the faith. We're not going to let up. When we're pushed back, we're going to stand up. Father, I thank you for the work of grace that is here right now as your people stand before your presence, and the strongholds that have been in their life and the lies of Satan that they bought into unaware of, and Father, the things that they have deprioritized concerning your call upon their life. Today, right now, in Jesus' name, it's broken. Today, right now, every unholy alliance broken. In the name of Jesus Christ, every earthly identity that has been received and accepted, no longer, it's rejected in Jesus' name. It's rejected in Jesus' name. Right now in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name. I break every stronghold right now. Every power that would bind you. Now in Jesus' name. Father, I ask that everybody in here begin to see how beautiful it is to walk in your love and your peace and your joy and your goodness in your life. That those riches become more riches, more important to them, more valuable to them than anything else. Oh, Rabba Gadaste, Rabba Gadaste Kiniste, Ribasa Deinak, Ribasta Deine, Mamanda Leapa, Malanda Beafese, Malangadesh, Malangade. No longer hanging on to yourself. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. Just be broken before his presence. Manda Deiste. That's right. It's not something that you can create. It's something God the Holy Ghost creates. Now in Jesus' name. Now in Jesus' name. This whole house. This whole house. Abresist. Menangaleshti. Malanga brefetest. Malanga reste brefetist. Malanga dusse brefetist. Malanga leshti bist. Maranda redesti. Iris turist. Marana nane. Monasticist. Take my life and let it be. Sicambre vest consecrated, Lord, to take my moments and my days. Jeez. Let them flow in ceaseless prayer. Father, upon the altar of sacrifice, we offer up our lives as an offering, a whole burnt offering. Oh God, turned into smoke. Peace.
visto. Padre, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. There's no sacrifice too great. There's no sin so worth valuing that you would abdicate. Wisdom in Jesus' name. Bambrosa. The heavenly call, the heavenly vision to be made. Not just noblemen in the kingdom of God, but priests and kings. To be made priests and kings and rather want to be a garbage man. A teacher, a lawyer, a doctor, a famous entrepreneur. No. Don't look back. Don't, having set your hand to the plow, now look back. Having set your hand to the plow, having realized what God has made you in Christ Jesus, a priest and a king, having anointed you with a sacred anointing, more than the holy oil from the horn of Samuel, but having anointed you with the Holy Ghost, having poured out abundantly upon you of His goodness, let Him shape you, let Him mold you as He will, let Him fashion you in the fire, if that's what He chooses. Let Him have His way. Let Him have His way. Not one hair falls from your head. Not one tear from your eye that is not measured. Let Him have His way. You take up your mantle. And let all the world hate you and reject you if it will. Father will stand with you throughout the ages. Hear me. Sadurinas dext. Sutarinistika must. Manbrachti ishi. Manrasata. Manrasatananish. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Wisdom and understanding. Mamrabasa donavekast. Beristan. Beristutananebexti. Lord, take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine. Take my heart. It is your own. It shall be your royal throne. As a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable God, I offer myself to you this day. Oh Lord, consecrated with the consecration that you made, set apart with that which you separated unto yourself this day. Have your way. Whether we live or whether we die, the mantle's far more valuable. The mantle's far more valuable than any earthly interest. Nothing can compare. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Any choice that you make that diminishes your commitment and your consecration to God is demonic. It's nothing to do with heaven's wisdom. Anything that diminishes your purpose and your pursuit of that which God ordained is demonic by fruit and by nature. Renounce it now. Renounce it now. I said renounce it now. Renounce it now. Renounce it, lest it bind you. Renounce it. Mosadeshi. Mosadesh de Barnophysi. Magli. Mosadani. Mangle, Mostarade, Mareste, Molestificast, Istrina Mandalete, Istrina Mandaliste, Borest, Bost, right now, in Jesus' name. Let the Spirit of the Lord come upon you. The anointing of the Holy Ghost overwhelm you. But now, in Jesus' name, a shift, a change. Now, in Jesus' name. Mate, Frete. Now in Jesus' name. Mingo Brasif. Mambrevetist. Now. Now. Right now. Bevrist. Jesus.
Come.
Now.
Mombrist. Mabatist. Mabethrist. Say, hear my, Lord. Send me. 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 Receive it. Hear my, Lord. Send me. Hear my. Send me. Hear my. Hand of God's upon you. The anointing of the Holy Ghost upon you. You just say, hear my, Lord. Send me. I'm yours to live fully for you. So I receive all the fullness that you give. Will springing, river flowing now. Right out of your belly flows. Rivers of the Holy Ghost. Mangayana manjesi sita. Mambredena manas. Mena mana neelea mosisi. Membranangea sisitis. Mamanayana nea manaya nisayana mangoyana. Mandesi atia bebe betisie. Mayana nambe ramanda sotukune. Mianayana mandesia. Out of your belly flows this wonderful glory of the Holy Ghost. Dearest, just receive. As many as receive. As many as receive. As many receive Him. As many as receive Him. 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 I have received Jesus into my life. As many as received Him. He came in. He came in. Let him come in today. He came in to rule. He came in to reign. He came in to show you the ways of life everlasting. He came in to bring the change from hell to heaven, from just a mere existence of a human being to living in the glories of the only begotten Son, to live out sonship with Him. Moshe ta, Moshe pate ram, time Moshe ke. Father, the millennials are coming. The millennials are coming. The millennials are coming. They care not for the Western fantasy. They care not. They care not for men's riches. They value not those things that men hold most valuable and sacred. Baddest, most. Now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now in Jesus' name. Now. 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 Now in Jesus' name. Now you take hold of God. Now you take hold of God. And you break the curse off your seed. Bosataradast. Mengjashapotapra. Mundefekist, Mumbrevis, Mimbrevisist. Mama, the millennials are coming. The millennials are coming. But the millennials are coming. Nebrast. Mevest. To take up a heavenly identity, to take up the very life of Christ Jesus, to be different from all other men. Mandusisist. Ist. Ista. Ista Berene, Ista Berenea, Ista Prinukasht, Zezus, Debra Sanda Situsi. The millennials are coming, reserving nothing for themselves. The millennials are coming. Dominique, you make sure you're in all Ruth Anna's meetings. You make sure. We're not going to stand by and watch you get left out of what only the church by the Holy Ghost can supply. Hasta Dane. Hasta Danea. Hasta Danea Pekadisht. Hasta Demeshtu. Esterimast. Jesus. Esterimast. Esterimast. Mazezusi. Esterimastin. Mondasevi. Esterimast. In Jesus. Mangerisht. In Jesus' name. Mola namast. Miesterimast. Right out of your belly flows rivers of the Holy Ghost. Right out of your belly flows Deserinaya. Right out of your innermost being, right out of your passions, right out of your emotions. God wants to begin to move in your passions. He wants to begin in your move in your emotions. That's where the river flows. He wants to make your passions and your emotions red hot for Him. Yeah, He does. Yeah, He does. Yeah, He does. Yes, He does. Father wants to turn your passions and your emotions on. Mando zegeya. Membrisiza. Nembambrist. Membrivist. Ekironost. Risarama. Vikandalable. In the name of Jesus. Look at me. Say, Lord Jesus, fill me. Turn my passions and my emotions on for you.
Turn my passions and emotions on for you.
Receive right now. Receive. Receive right now. Take what He has to give. He gives it free. It's free. It's free. It's free. It's free. It's free. It's free. Robust. It's free. Thank you, Jesus. It's free. Thank you, Jesus.
In the day when I cried, the Lord answered me and strengthened me with strength in my soul. The Lord comes to give strength to your souls today. Your prayers have been answered. No longer is it your battle. The battle is His and the battle is won.
Yes.
Today you walk out of this place not the way you came in, but you are strengthened. You are equipped to take this city for Jesus. Don't go back to the way you came. Don't walk out of this place and go back into those filthy garments. You have been renewed. You've been washed clean today. And you've been strengthened by the Lord Jesus Christ. And you put on your you put on your armor every single day in this city. And you take the city for Jesus Christ. In Jesus' mighty name, today is our day, church. Today is the church that we rise up. We rise up. And we are equipped for the spiritual battle. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, mighty God.
Jesus. Lord Jesus. the most glorious thing that we have the privilege of being and doing is living the life of Jesus. You have to understand that the powers of darkness, the world around you, is a weapon and a tool that is used very effectively against God's people from really ever stepping into this glory realm of heaven. You have to decide. You have to make up your mind. You have to have a determined will. There cannot be any wiggle room in your opinion, in your decision, in your consecration. Otherwise, the enemy is a master at his subtle lie and deception. You take a hold of God. Whether you live or the resolve, the complete consecration. Whether we live or whether we die, we're going to do exactly what you said to do. We're going to believe it the way you described it. We're going to do it as you've commanded.
Amen.
And then in this, you're going to be shaped. In this process, you're going to be shaped. This process of growing and maturing, being prepared. And there's a lot of things in your life that you've allowed that Father just will not even, he won't tolerate it. He will not allow it to go on. You won't step, he will hold back many of the things that he would have otherwise, it would have been a quick route to the blessing, as it were. He will just hold it back. One dear brother said, you want heaven, get rid of the leaven.
Yes.
It's really got to come down to that, people. It's got to come down to that. There's all kinds of doctrines and ideas, but reality of it is Christ Jesus has stepped into our life to bring heaven so that we can live out heaven. Days of heaven upon this earth. Just make what he's done for you and who he is your riches, that which is most valuable to you. Find every place you possibly can to be taught of the Holy Ghost, to sit at the feet of Jesus, his word, study of his word. This place of intimacy, of prayer, of just enjoying his presence, talking to him, interacting with him in the place that we call prayer. It becomes a glory realm in your life, a place where heaven, well, really, Holy Ghost meetings are extended, put it that way. Make the things of God first. Make church first. Make the meeting place first. Watch what Father will do. Just we on it, on the precipices of the great outpourings of God upon the earth. But to be on the precipices of seeing the great outpourings of God in the earth, you've got to be in the midst of the great outpourings of God in your life. I'm in the midst of a Holy Ghost revival. I'm in the midst of a Holy Ghost awakening. I'm in the midst of a Holy Ghost moving. Hallelujah. This is what God's called us to be. And so in so doing, I can be a part of what Father's about to do in the world around me, for the lost and dying world around me. Come on, people. You make sure that you don't miss church. Do not deprioritize church at all for any reason. Ever. Ever. But assemble yourself all the more as you see the day approaching.
Yes, amen.
In Jesus' name. I was telling somebody this the other day. Just to let you know, because there's many people that have done this. We used to, when we were bivocational, just pouring money into the church, not receiving money from the church, doing everything we could do for the church and in the framework of what we understood of moving in faith. And we get up in the morning, go to work 6 o'clock in the morning, work till about 4:30, 5 o'clock in the afternoon, drive directly to church because we had church every night. I'd get home from church, and I'd usually work, till late on. I wrote 3 books during that time. I'd work till late, 1, 2 o'clock in the morning. John, help me do 2 CDs. We'd get out of church, go to the studio, be in the studio till 3 o'clock in the morning. I found a place of the anointing. I found a place of refreshing, A place where you can do all these things. Yes. Keep God first.
Yes.
Because I'll tell you right now, you stay faithful to God, you win.
Yes.
You win. Yes. The mantle's much, the mantle that you've received. The mantle, you hear me? Lucy and Dale, the mantle is on your life is much bigger than anything that you've ever done up to this point. It's much bigger. It's much bigger. But it has to be the most sacred thing to you. It has to be the biggest thing in your life. You have to sell everything to have it. Everything else has to be devalued. Otherwise, you never step into it. This goes for every one of you. I'm saying this to every one of you. Every single person in this place. Some of you, you've never really even began, even in understanding the opportunity that God made room for you. He made room for you among the mighty. He made room for you. Not just at the table with those that are like his mighty angels. We've made room for you in his only begotten son, Jesus. He made room for you to be able to participate in something that goes beyond a description. We can liken it to Enoch, and we can liken it to Elijah, and we can liken it to Moses, and we can liken it to Paul, but it's an expression that can only be found in Jesus. That we failed to fully realize. But if you'll press in, if you are not weary in well-doing, let me just tell you right now, if there wasn't a period of time and a season that everybody has to go through, there would be no opportunity to weary. You shall reap if you faint not. Understand, if there wasn't challenges and a preparation time, there'd be no opportunity to faint. What you got to understand is do not weary and do not faint. Somebody said, please tell me, how can I understand how not to weary and how not to faint?
They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
Yes.
They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Amen.
I tell you right now, the anointing of the Holy Ghost is upon me. I have a bright, fiery sword of the Word of God breaking off the yokes and the chains and the things that would bind you. So just as Ali was saying, you walk out of here freed, freed, freed of the oppression, freed of the things, wrong decisions, wrong choices. Somebody said, how do I get back to where I was? A decision. How do I move forward in God? A choice. Father still responds only to the name of Jesus. Heaven still responds only to obedience to the Word of God. So just do it. And find yourself living glorious. And hook up with the provision. And I really hear this for you, Dominique. And I know Karen. So it's for you and Karen because your mom's right there. You've got to hook up. You've got to be in all the meetings. God's doing something special. In the youth, you've got to be in all of them. Don't deprioritize it. Someone come pick you up if you need. Whatever. But I've been doing checkup. I've been watching. I can tell you who's in all the meetings. I can see the anointing. There's an anointing. There's Thursday night meetings. There's a gifting. The millennials are coming, and they're special. Somebody said, the millennials think they're special. They are.
Yes, they are.
Special. Even just look at the landscape of the millennials. They don't care. The landscape of millennials, just initial. They don't care about all the other stuff that everybody else has been seeking after. They're just wild. They're carefree. Huh? They're special. They don't need to go to school. Come on, man. Yeah. Something's happening.
Yeah.
Something happening.
Yeah.
And I might not be a millennial in that sense, but I will be right in the big middle of it. And I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, every one of you will lay hold on God. Lay hold on God. Lay
hold on eternal life. Lay hold on the very life of God. Begin to grab a hold of all that Father has promised and realize that it is there. All that He's promised, it is there for the passion of it, for the hunger of it, for the thirsting of it, for the desiring of it, for the giving Him no rest day or night until all these things are realized in your life.
Cesar Ribos de Si. Nambanga Yerkete Yakiyo. Nambada Kishte Kana Ate Yapasta.
Thank you, Father. Father, I thank you for provision.
Father, I thank you for a great provision that the anointing brings. Hallelujah. Harapasai. I thank you for a great provision, Father. Hasipriteya. The blessing of provision that comes when someone has been anointed with holy oil, anointed of the Holy Ghost. Mamrafataya. A great development. Fire. Holy Ghost. Faith. Basumbrathith. And wisdom. Spirit knowledge to speak it forth, and it happens. Thank you, Father, that this mantle that has been taken up, oh God, shall be fully realized. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to me. Take my moments and my days, and let them flow in ceaseless praise. Oh, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine. Take my heart, it is thine. It shall be your royal throne. It shall be your royal. Hallelujah.
It shall be your royal throne. Hallelujah. Seen by all the world to be your royal throne. Thank you, Jesus. Narrow is the way that leads unto life. Few there be that find it. Be one of the few. Labor, agonize to enter into the straight gate. Labor to enter into the rest, lest a promise being left to you, any of you should fall short of it. Recognize today there's only one way. Take up your cross and follow Jesus. Deny yourself. Come live out this life. Where you no longer live, but it's God living, Christ Jesus living, by definition, being that which He expressed in His short sojourn here in 3.5 years, but has broken out with such wisdom and insight and detail in His Word. Keep yourself to these things and watch what Father will do to your life. Be consecrated to live in His life. Watch what Father would do. In Jesus' name. Amen. Honor the Lord with your whole life. Honor the Lord with your substance. With all the first fruits of your increase. Take your life, sow it. Hallelujah.
And watch what he will do. Watch what the fruits of the move of God that will begin to happen in your life. Think about the inheritance that he has in you. How many souls are going to come into the kingdom because of the inheritance he has in you? How many people are going to hear? How many people are going to be saved? How many people are going to be transformed? How much of the glory of heaven is going to be realized because you're willing to go all the way with him? Hallelujah. Find a bunch of people around you. Hug them. Tell them that you love them. Bless them in the name of Jesus. Worship the Lord with your giving. This is pretty. Especially the giving of your life. The giving of your time. Nando sekiel la mahata, manon de bevivi, havre de beve, mamande mastekiela, mambande de bevivi ki sebrist, Jesus, brevistu, sebristu, shivatust, sebristu, shivrastu, mananda kiena mushipa, havre mamamana fina, havre mamamana fina, havre mamana masisekiela, irre mamane shikamo, irre mamamana shikana. Papa loves you so much.
Eric said you can contact him right now.
Okay, good.
You ready?
Okay,
good. Your answer is faster than a phone call.
Okay.
Because the phone constantly ringing.
Okay.
So you can email him.
Okay.
And God bless you.
Bless you. Thank you. Si cambra ve vechi dice re danono masavrava. Maranda re ve ve vechi se re danono la labusaya. Ebre ve manubracando la re vechikindo la labhara. Membre bebe kindo lo busi andare da bebe kindo la la ma nananda la le miniante lo non lo mossi premi ora satana. Father, we give our lives completely to you, a whole burnt offering, Father, a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. Oh Lord, let our lives be in every way poured out before you as a drink offering, oh God. Oh Lord, may in dambo sebeli every part of our being be passionate about living only for you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Zizurina namanda de kiste bredesu salarandi. Jesus. Rivera shikida la nanana masaya. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Yashikara balabatana. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Every day I walk with you is a day of glory lived. Every day I walk with you. It's a day of glory lived. And every time I talk with you, it's a realm that's all I need. It's a realm that fills me. Manny, come here. Jesus. Jesus. Koristanda la kikia na nakataya. Mondaya mama dosinga. Mondaya mama kosinga. Mondaya mama kushikana. Mondaya namasite. Mayim pritetea shikana. Ha ha ha! Mandeya stebrunaya, mong lesta. Deeper still, mambanda veya. Deeper still, mambanda keopo. Bavre nefihi shikina nashaboya. Deeper still, mambanda lefist. Ha!
Father, I thank you for this fire that you lit. Now let it begin to burn bright. Mambas de de pre deif. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Jesus. Thank you, Lord, that you broke off every yoke. Thank you, Lord, that you've removed every hindrance out of the way. And that by your name, not only does salvation come, but healing from sickness and disease is established. Thank you. Matasa de rene kita no moshi. Istilina. Malangalus de perisufra. Zer in a makes is italono motapatea. Zeg in a manjesus itada. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Field overflowing. Field overflowing. Well springs of heaven flowing. Gifts of God now flowing. Flowing through you. Flowing through you, flowing through you, flow through Flande, Proshande, Potaneke, flowing through you, flow, flow out the rivers of God, flowing through you. Menana manana mandere ne menegana na mandere city. Mumbandana na mandamana mandere ne menene balana kipiyala na mandabala too. Jesus, Jesus. Kiri mama mama ndola la la na manjeri de de manok pat ne veni ne ne no 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 mondere de maya. Zura mama mama ne ya na la mangu na 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 la manda re be 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 kutishia. Mo mama manda mo no na 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 mamba ro manda re be fikenia. Zusa na 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 la man ne 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 na mo kutere ne me. Zusa de re ora. Jesus arana si si lo lo man na si. Holy is the Lord our God. Holy is the Lord our God. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord our God. Brahma, mama, blessing and honor, blessing and honor, blessing and honor belongs unto him through us. Ah, blessing and honor. Praises without him belongs unto him, flowing from us to him, flowing out of us, praises and honor and blessings to him. Let the earth be filled with his praise. Let this earth be filled with his praise. Evening and morning and at noon will I praise. Oh, with continually seeking his face, let all praises fill this earth of my life. All praise belongs to him. Evening and morning and at noon continually will I bless the Lord. I will sing praises unto the Lord my King. I will sing praises unto his holy name. I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless and praise him. I will sing in the midst of the congregation. I will magnify the Lord. I will exalt his name. Continually I will seek his face. I will seek his fame. I will praise him evening and morning and at noon. I will lift my voice in song. I will rejoice evermore. I will bless the Lord all continually with all that is within me. I will sing praises in the congregation of the saints. I will magnify the Lord. I will exalt his name. I will praise him continually. I will worship before the throne of his majesty.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. I will make my boast in you, O God. I will praise you continually, evening, morning, and at noon. I will sing praises to the Lord. I will rejoice evermore. I will seek his face continually. I will magnify the Lord. Be exalted, O God, in me, and I will sing praise in the congregation, on the assembly of the saints. I will magnify the Lord, and I will bless my God and my Savior continually. I will magnify the Lord. I will bless him with all that I am and all that I have. I will make my boast in thee. O Lord, my God, O Lord of the ages, eternally, hallelujah, in spirit and in truth, like a wellspring springing, rivers flowing, water pouring, rains now falling, glory glowing, fire burning, I will bless the Lord. Oh, I will bless the Lord, evening, morning, and at noon. I will magnify the Lord. I will exalt the Lord. I will praise him continually. Hallelujah. Sitana manchean. Sitana manchean. Sayana mangina. Ha ha ha. Mane da banton dante pahu. Ha ha rebatia. Ha satita sedehi. Tu. Na na no manchike dona mande breman batipi. Oh, come bless the Lord with me. Come magnify the Lord continually. Come seek his face forevermore. Rejoice in the Lord our God. Rejoice evermore. Oh, shout unto the Lord with a voice of triumph. Oh, exalt his name forever. Oh, Ramamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamamam mouth continually. My heart shall make his boast in you, O God, my King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm my beloved's and he's mine. I'm living this life in him. Every moment spent in Jesus is the moments of divine. Every day in him is the day divine. Hallelujah. When I talk with you, oh God, it's all I need. You're my bread of life, and you quench the thirst for me. Drink indeed, bread of life, oh, water my soul. Jesus be magnified in me.